Yo, what is good, everybody? Welcome back to another video. Hopefully you guys are having an awesome day filled with only positive vibe. First of all, I'm wearing a hat because my hair's a mess. Don't want to talk about it. Second of all, you guys are insane. We have, 2,000 likes in 48 hours on that last video. I didn't think you guys really wanted to see this video, but apparently you guys really want to see every single gold skin in the game. So if you guys ever want to, you know, get a reference on which gold skin you want to grind, you can check this video out. So hopefully that helps you guys out. I will do the same thing for Damascus if we hit 3,000 like. I actually said I would set a like goal extremely high so that way gives me more time to work on it, so I don't actually have to do this in 2 days. But if we get to 3,000, we'll actually start working on Damascus one similar to that. And then finally, my birthday is happening on December 21st. If we can hit 150,000 subscribers, that'd be mad appreciated. Matter of fact, I think 60% of you guys who are watching my videos are not subscribed, so just hit that subscribe button if you do enjoy this content. Anyway, this is gonna be a longer video. Hope you guys enjoy the rest of the video, and I'll see you guys at the end. There is something you guys note. Most guns will have no attachments on three specific things: this back of the stock, the handle, the top of the thing where the iron sight is, and then I believe sometimes the magazine. But there is going to be attachments that will change that. For example, let's look at the killer bolt action. This is the first gun we're looking at today. Base one is actually pretty nice. The only downside is that the gold kind of looks weird and the back part. So as a gold one, it's actually really nice. But if you add ammo, does it change anything? It doesn't really change anything. The barrel also really doesn't change usually, and the muzzle also. So the muzzle generally doesn't change. The only thing that really does change, typically speaking, is the stock, the barrel, and the ammunition. You guys can see, not that much gold in game. Take some shots here. We'll hit the reload button to see if you guys can see. Yeah, it's not great. So that's the camo bolt. The shotgun, you guys can see, if you add a barrel, it'll just extend it a little bit, but it doesn't add any gold. The stock, you guys will see, it kind of just changes the back more than anything, just like the killer bolt action. And then if you add a laser sight, those will typically not add anything, so we're not even gonna look at that. Neither does the underbarrel. So really the three things we'll take a look is the ammo, which this one makes it kind of whack, and the rear grip usually ruins it. So really the three things you want to check is the stock, the barrel, and the ammo, which is the three things we're gonna check. HS 2126 scoping in, it's good. It actually a lot of gold, which is really great. Let's see how they shoot. You're not gonna notice the reload animation. Actually, it's not that much. BY-15 is actually really, really nice. If you don't have the barrel on or any stock, it's just gonna have black in the back and then the barrel. But if you add the barrel, any of the barrel, or actually make it full gold. So I typically use this one. And then if you want, you can actually have this one a little bit. Depends really what you have. Obviously, some of it is not gonna be gold, but it makes it less pronounced. And then you add any of the no stocks. Steady stock is usually one that I usually use, Ranger as well, but no stock as well. No stock actually looks pretty good. It's kind of full gold. And then ammo doesn't, you typically don't want to use any ammo on shotguns, honestly. You can see a lot of gold. I actually love it. Take a shotgun shot real quick. We're going to reload. Yeah, looks pretty nice. And then we have the HS, which pretty good, but the barrel doesn't really do anything. It just makes it longer, which actually makes it kind of worse, in my opinion. Stock, you can't really use much stock, but if you do want to use the YKM stock, it'll look pretty nice, but it's not really useful. I don't know why it has the bullets already on the side. It seems to be a little more shiny than the other ones for some odd reason. Hit that reload button real quick. Not a fan of the reload because you don't really see much more of the gold, but whatever, it is what it is. It's not what I recommend. Striker, such a missed opportunity. It looks kind of weird. Like for example, if you add this, it just doesn't do really anything. It just makes it longer. You can add like a combat stock, or the stalker stock. It does look kind of cool with the stalker stock. It makes it more look like a gun. Ammunition will actually change this one with the shotgun. That will actually kind of change with it, which that's pretty cool. The gold looks more like dirt. Like it looks dirty, so it doesn't look great. And we'll reload. Yeah, when you reload it, you can see it a little bit better. We'll take the KRM. The KRM is probably the ugliest. Even the barrel, I believe, doesn't really change much. If you add the extended barrel here, you can see it just makes it longer, but the middle part is still going to have that gray, which you don't really like as much. And then the no stock, or even the stalker stock, depending on what you use. Stalker stock is actually pretty decent, to be honest with you guys. KRM, again, a lot of non-gold, which makes it really awkward. But let's go ahead and reload real quick. Yeah, the reload doesn't show much, so that kind of sucks as well. But gold echo is already really nice. And then if you add the ammo, it makes it very, 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 except for the slug round. Don't use echo slug round. You're going to regret it. But yeah, typically if you use this, again, you lose out a bit of the gold, but it looks kind of neat. The barrel also is going to extend, which is always nice to have. And then also the stock. I wouldn't run it no stock, but stalker stock is not bad if you want to do the ADS speed. So scope in, reload. Oh, that's pretty cool. I kind of like the base mag a little bit better, but that's just me. So we're starting off with the RUS it's not bad base, but the ammo, the ammunition is really, the mag is really where it loses out on value. But however, you add a mag on it, which I would recommend the 38 fast mag. It looks really nice and clean, so that's really nice. The barrel will also extend it a little bit, so typically you might even use a YKM. It looks really good, and the stock is also going to look very, very good. All right, well, this is the RUS. You guys can check how it looks. Take a shot, reload. The mag is gold, which is great. Take another shot, reload. All right, I'm not a huge fan of this, the chicken, but I think the barrel will help it out a little bit. Just a little bit, not too much. You still get that ugly part in the middle, and then the stock is pretty... eh. And then let's see if you add a grip. No, not the grip, the bullets. Yeah, and the ammo doesn't even change color, so you're like, well, what's the point, right? What's the point? Pretty ugly, real talk. When you aim in, it actually, this is one of the only that has the iron sight and gold, which is hilarious. But reloading, you guys see the mag is not gold, which kind of sucks. We're gonna go to the PDW, which if we add a barrel will just extend the ugliness, so that's a no bueno for me, chat. And then the stocks is gonna be same for all the other ones, and there's no ammo you can add, so really that's the best option you have. PDW in game looks absolutely terrible. There's so much black, even the top part, you know, when you have to reload, it's just not there. We're reloading, it looks pretty bad. Actually, it looks not that bad when you're like in the sun, but overall pretty terrible. So that's gonna be for the PDW. actually, the Razorback was not bad if I remember correctly. The barrel, you can extend it, which not really great, but we will add one for you guys and see the stock. Yeah, there's not much change you can do if you add the combat stock, which is something I would use just because the ADS is pretty important for this. And then not the rear grip, the ammo will be gold, so that's actually really cool. Gold Razorback looks actually in the game, it looks really good. And then you reload, it's actually really nice as you shoot it. This gold is actually way nicer than the other one, so that's actually pretty nice. Switching class real quick, MSMC is, you have the ammo, which you would probably use the 30 fast reload in my opinion. It looks really nice. The barrel is gonna extend as well, it's gonna be nice, which I think you use a Ranger. And then the stock, you can do a no stock, which is ugly, but you can also add a strike stock, so that could look pretty nice. Yeah, it's not that great compared to the other one. It looks way more like dirty kind of a gold more than anything. So HG40, which I'm sure a lot of people would be interested in. The barrel will increase it. If you use the integral, which I feel like most people will be using it, it does look kind of weird. So keep that in mind when you're building it. It's based on aesthetic. Marksman is always good. It also makes it look very weird. It does look really weird. Skeleton stock's one of my favorite when it comes to how it looks. So I'm actually going to put that down, and then we'll put the ammo. 40 round fast reload. All right, HG40 again, same thing. Some of the older guns look really like the gold is like more dirty than anything, and then you can't really tell how it looks. Maybe if you crawl in, that's not that bad. And then we had the Pharaoh, which you add the ammo, you're just probably gonna go to 36 fast reload. You're gonna increase the barrel. You can use this one. It doesn't do anything. It just increases the barrel, which is ugly, so not worthwhile. We're just gonna leave it there. And then the stock. That's cool. The stock does change the color, which I think you would go with this one here. It's actually really good, actually, in game. Again, the gold is, like I said, some of the older guns, the gold just doesn't look as good, right? The reload looks nice, though. All right, now we're going to put this one. 32 mag fast reload is usually what you're going to use. It actually looks really cool with that. We increase the barrel, which I think you can use the integral, but the integral looks so ugly. Gosh, dang. Yeah, the barrel is not going to increase any of this, the gold on it. But we are going to use integral because I think that's something you would use. And you would probably use the steady stock or combat stock. So we'll just have whatever has the most gold. JKS is actually really nice. Again, some of the older guns, the gold is not that pronounced. We'll reload it one more time. You guys can see it pretty well when you reload, so that's pretty good. Cordite, I think a lot of people love this one. However, it is not that great. The barrel will increase, which is always fantastic to see. The stock will also increase. But honestly, the middle part is the important part. Like the fact that it doesn't change color makes it really, really ugly. The thing about the Cordite is that the giant mag in middle, you can literally see it, so it kind of blocks out all the gold. But other than that, it's not bad. The top part, the middle part, QQ9 is actually really nice, especially when you add the ammo. I think I personally use a 45 mag. Some people might use a 10 mag, but they look exactly the same in game. So don't even worry about it. Right? Don't even worry about it. This is great. The mag being changed to the monolithic, I think people would like to use, but I personally like using the tactical barrel just because you get a little more. Even the recon, either or is good. We'll put the recon because it makes it look a little nicer. And the stock, we'll put the strike stock. It looks good when you're like reloading, but when you're like in that angle, kind of weird. Not bad at all. A lot of gold, which you would love to see. So that is actually really good. I love the Fennec. I put Akimbo we're probably gonna take a look at Kimbo, but we're gonna do that afterwards. We'll have two classes, one Akimbo and one no Akimbo, and then afterwards we're gonna go ahead and let's go ahead. We have to show you guys the base. Then you add the ammo, which is the extended mag or the fast reload, depends what you really want. And you add a barrel. It's weird to me that you actually gain more by adding more stuff to it. And then the stock, let's see the steady stock, how it looks. It kind of looks really weird. Base Fennec, you guys can see with the attachments, reloading it. See, like, this one looks so much better than the other one. You guys know what I'm talking about? Like, the other one looked almost like a dirty kind of gold. This one looks like a shiny gold, especially when you reload. So, yeah, that's the Fennec. For some reason, the Akimbos look so good. It kind of makes the gun smaller, but it looks so nice. S36 right now with put some stuff on. It's pretty ugly, but if you add an ammo, hopefully it's gold. It is, but it's the ugly gold thing. We're going to go ahead and check the barrel. Adding the barrel is actually really nice, so that's good. We'll put the long one real quick. And then we're going to go ahead and add a stock, which steady stock is probably what you want to use, or even the combat stock. It depends. S36 actually looks really good in game. The reload is going to make it look pretty nice. We're going to go ahead and have the ammo added to this. 60 round mag, 50 round mag, doesn't really matter. They both look ugly. The barrel, that's even worse. This is the worst gun. You're just going to put a long barrel on this. Essentially, that's what it does. And then even the stock is probably going to be super ugly. So with the giant mag, this is the one thing I didn't like about this UL, is that with the giant mag, it just takes off so much of the screen. You can see just prone. Whatever. It does have a lot of gold though, so that's actually really cool. Let's just reload. Very similar to the S36 when I was talking about the gold looking kind of whack. All right, RPD is going to look really good, I think. So if you add the ammo, that sucks, man. That sucks. If you put any belt or any ammo, it doesn't get gold, so you kind of lose out on that. The barrel just gets longer or shorter depending on what you want to do, so it's really an L. And then the stock, yeah, I mean, you can add a steady stock. It'll look good, but with the ammo, it looks terrible. So for this situation, we're actually going to take off the ammo so you guys can see how it looks. RPD is actually really nice. The gold is actually way more pronounced. You don't even notice the front part or the back part, so let's reload it. You don't really notice the reload, so that's kind of stupid, but it's okay. I think we should be able to prone, and you guys will be able to see it a little bit better. M4 LMG. The ammo will still be gold, so that's good. We're actually going to put it with the ammo. We're going to put the short barrel, ultralight barrel, whatever you guys want to put. It does make it longer, which is great, and then we'll put the steady stock. M4 LMG, pretty nice, actually. To be honest, the iron sight is going to be really whack. Reload looks really nice. I kind of like that a lot. So nice. Not bad for the M4 LMG. The chopper. I love the chopper. My favorite. Looks even better when you go put, like, hear me out. This is the only gun that has this make it look. I thought the heavy handle would be gold, but it's not. So it's not worth it. People are telling me to put the heavy handle to make it look nicer, but it doesn't. That's a lie. That was a fat cap. I was lied to. The barrel. Ooh, okay. The barrel is good. You're typically not going to go with the chopper heavy. I think you go with the infantry. And then the stock. Strike stock. People tell me to put the handle. We'll put the handle for those who want to see how it looks. Like I mentioned, fan favorite. But this is the build that people will use. It's going to use the handle, which makes it kind of worse. But you can actually still see a lot of gold on that. So that's actually pretty good. And then if you reload, bang. Looks really nice actually when you reload, so that's actually pretty cool. XPR is actually a really nice one. If you add the ammo, it's also really cool. Put the stopping power, because I think that's what most people will be using. Stock also is gonna be gold, so that's always nice to see. It doesn't really matter. It kind of looks really, really weird. The barrel here is gonna change. It's gonna be longer, so it's not really worth changing. So as you guys can see, it's like I said, older skins look really bad. Like, the waves on this one kind of makes it look really bad, but you can really tell on this gun how the camo looks. Actually, not bad if I remember correctly. So, stopping power is going to be gold. The barrel is going to be extended, so that's good. Anti-material heavy. Did not know there was a thing. I didn't know if they had a monolithic suppressor on that either. Wow, impressive. Actually, you're probably going to use this. And then we'll put the skeleton stock. Skeleton stock looks ugly, so we'll put this one steady stock as well. All right, let's take a look at the Arctic. Love the Arctic because the iron sight is going to be gold. You take a look here, aim it in. That's good. Reload it real quick. Very nice reload, actually. You see a lot of gold when you reload it. Pretty nice. EBR, I think it is whack, if I remember correctly. It doesn't have a gold ammo. The barrel just extends a little bit, but it just adds more less gold or more not gold or whatever you want to call it, especially the steady. Gosh dang, that's terrible. M21 EBR, yeah, I mean, it looks a little bit better, but it's still kind of whack. Yeah, the magazine, everything. And it's not much gold, so we're just gonna skip on to the next one. All right, let's go ahead and move on to the next one, which is DLQ. Take a look at this. With the ammo, it does not change it, so that's a very awkward moment there. And then the barrel also doesn't change it, so it kind of makes it really whack. And then the stock, it does change, but not much. Yeah, not that great, but we'll take a shot, reload real quick. Yeah, this is like a little different too. I guess all the golds have the wavy pattern, I just never noticed. Locust is absolutely the worst. You add the ammo, which is, at least it's gonna be gold. The barrel, it just extends it, so it doesn't really matter. The stock, also same issue. You're generally speaking gonna be using the skeleton stock. Yeah, the gold locust does not look too great. I mean, there's a little bit of gold in the back, which is the best part, I guess, because that's where the majority of the, you can see, but you can see how it looks when we reload. At least the mag is gold, so that's better than some of the other guns on this list. I just gravity spikes, don't know why, but whatever. We're gonna go to NA45, which I believe also is pretty bad, but it does have the mag already in gold, so that's cool. You don't need to add a mag, but I think probably you might go high explosive damage. The stock is really a small thing, so it doesn't really matter, but we play with that. The barrel, that's kind of cool. It does add more gold, so that makes it a little bit better. All right, the NA45. Let's see the reload. Actually looks really good. We'll just reload once. Outlaw, very beautiful. Ammo, we'll add a 9 mag. If you add a barrel, it's very nice. Which I usually use MIP tack long, and then stock where you go with the note. I usually go skeleton stock, question mark? I actually love this one. It looks so good in game. Reload it as well. Reloading. Oh my god. My favorite. Like in game, this is probably one of the best. Like it looks so good in game. Type 25. We add the ammo, which is here. They fixed it. The stopping power used to be non-gold, so that makes it really nice. The barrel is going to extend, which is fantastic. And then we also have the stock, which I wish they had the no stock, but you put the steady stock. As you guys see, type 25. Again, like I mentioned a lot of times before, the main reason it didn't make it to the top was because of the top part. But as you guys can see, the gold is actually one of the older ones, so it doesn't look too great. But let's do one more reload. And yeah, an M16, and we add the ammo. That's good to see. Barrel, hopefully it takes off the gray part, which it does. You probably will use the YCAM integral suppressor, but if you want to use the light, you can potentially do that. And you might even use a no stock to do like a fast ADS speed, but honestly, just put the strike stock to see how it looks. Again, one of the issues that I had was that little wheel that just, for some odd reason, they just put there, and the iron sight are really, really, really bad, but whatever. Other than that, the reload, pretty cool. Actually, let me reload it in the sun so you guys can see it. Not the best one, but still not bad. The 8K should look pretty good, honestly. 48 mag. I've used a 40 mag. The barrel should also change it. Nice. Love that. That's actually really good. You might use the integral if you want on this situation. We'll put the smaller one. I would typically use a smaller barrel, but it is what it is. And then we can probably go no stock usually, but we can put the steady stock here or the skeleton stock. Either or, it looks great on this. AK-117. We'll just reload this bad boy. It actually looks really good when you reload it. It's actually very shiny. Again, not all gold are the same. AK, absolutely terrible with no attachments. To be real with you guys, it has terrible base gold skin. However, once you start adding the ammo, it looks really good. The 45 mag is the only thing that doesn't have gold, which is, keep that in mind. I would typically put the extended mag here. Stock will be turned into gold, so that is going to be great, especially when you can put the strike stock. The barrel is going to be turned into gold, so that's always going to be great. So the AK-47 looks a lot better with the attachments on, so that's a added benefit. Would be a lot higher on the list if it had attachments on, but this is how the AK-47 looks. AK-710, I think it's in a very similar situation to some of the other guns we talked about. If you add a mag, it looks decent. The barrel doesn't remove anything, it just makes it longer, so we'll keep it. And then the stock, you'll probably use the no stock on this situation. All right, another popular gun, the ASM-10. You guys take a look. Reload as well. Not bad, not bad. Again, like I mentioned, a lot of the dark part makes it look not as great, but that is how the ASM-10 looks. And then we're gonna go through the M4, which I typically think it's a really nice one. If you add a 40 mag to this, ooh, beautiful. Increase the barrel. You really don't need to, honestly. Use the light one, I think. That's what I usually use. And I usually no stock, but that's just my style. So this is how the M4 looks. Scope in, reload. Again, some of these older skins kind of look a little bit worse, but again, if you reload in the air, it kind of looks really nice. So this is the M4. BK. All right, let's just check something. does the stop the large caliber mag. Okay, so you can put the large caliber mag. This is the same large caliber mag as HVK, but it doesn't do as well. We're gonna go ahead and add the okay, we're not gonna add any of these. It just doesn't do anything. And then the stock obviously is gonna be similar to the other ones, but yeah, skeleton stock is thick. What the heck? When did the BK get so thick? All right, the BK actually looks a lot better in game than it did in the thing, but that's probably because you don't see as much as the dark part from the front part. So overall, it's actually pretty good when you reload too. So that's the BK. Okay, 24. Yeah, like I said, it looks pretty bad, but if you add a mag and then you change the barrel, it'll look pretty good. I think most people are using incorrosive suppressor, so that's what we'll do here. And then the stock, we'll put the strike stock. So that looks a lot better. Ironside are poo-poo, but the gun skin itself looks fantastic, especially when you reload, you kind of see two mags, which I love. So that is going to be the LK24. And then we'll check out the ICR. I think the ICR looks a lot better with attachments. 40 fast reload. The barrel is the integral you might use, or OWC Ranger, which I'll just put the Ranger. And then we'll put the steady stock here. Why does it look so weird? What the heck is this? All right, this is the ICR. Kind of looks very similar to the M4, but wow, that's a, holy smokes, that's a fast reload. I guess I have the fast reload mag on this. Wow, I never realized the ICR had such a fast reload, but yeah, you guys see, this is the ICR. Reload. It's Manowar ammo. That's whack. That sucks, which is typically something you would actually have to put on it. Strike stock, that's great. The barrel, I think I use the Ranger. All right, this is the Manowar. We'll reload. Oh, the mag is actually gold in here. That's actually pretty cool. The Manowar mag is actually gold. Well, half gold. That's kind of cool. I wasn't sure which one it was. But yeah, it's actually better in game than I expected. KN, one of the better ones. 38 fast reload. You throw in the barrel there. I think it's a Ranger. Doesn't really matter. And you can put a nose stock, but you can put a strike stock as well. All right, this is the KN. I think it's one of the better ones, especially with attachments on. You can see everything gold except for the few black parts. But I think that makes it kind of okay since it's not that much. So yeah, KN, that's how it looks if you're interested in getting the KN. HBR was a really good one. Base, let's see how it looks with the attachments here. We're going to put the fast mag, or let's just put the fast mag. It's a little longer, so it makes it a little better. The barrel is going to just make it longer, so not really worthwhile. And then stock, same as the regular one. All right, this is the HBR. You guys can see the HBR. The gold is kind of weird in this one as well, so I think it just sometimes the reflection does that, but this is how the HBR looks if you guys are interested in the HBR. HVK, I think, was okay. Large caliber. No! Large caliber mag, why aren't you gold? Aw, man! There's no other reason to use it but that. Why? Well, we'll keep it like that. Stock is going to look gold, so that's good. Strike stock is what you're going to use, typically speaking. And I think we use the integral on this one, so would have been, you know, for purposes like that, we'll just see how it looks with the fast reload. So this is the HVK. If you guys are trying to get the HVK, this is how it looks. It's actually really nice in game. I actually like it a lot. Despite having quite a bit of black in the middle part, it is pretty nice, especially when you reload, you can kind of tell. So that is the HVK. DRH, the last one, which I think is the best one. Hopefully this will come out soon. The OTM mag and you add a barrel. Typically you will actually go with the, I go with the light because I usually add a monolithic. And then you add a no stock, but we'll just, for this situation, strike stock. Looks a little bit better. All right, finally, this is the DRH. I actually think is the nicest one that you have in the game. It is pretty nice, actually. Like, because the hand is holding that part, you don't actually see. I guess that's the grip part. So that's actually really nice. And then that is going to be our last gun. And hopefully that helps you guys out. You guys thought we were done, but we're not. There is knives. All right, just a knife. Let's show you guys a knife. The knife is meh. Whatevs. You don't really notice it as much. Like, it's cool and all, but like, it is what it is. Pretty nice. I've had this rank number 2, so that's why it's really good. The axe looks great. I've always mentioned this. The axe looks very, very nice. You guys can see, we'll swing it, we'll switch it out so you guys can see it again. And bang, axe looks really good. There's no baseball bat for say, but if you guys want to see what it potentially would look like with gold, this is how the gold would look, chat. Not really. It's not out yet. We'll take a look at the launchers. This is how the FHJ would look. FHJ looks, you guys see in game, not bad. We're gonna shoot, hit the reload. The reload doesn't show, so it doesn't really matter. And the SMRS, this is how it's gonna look. So SMRS, great. As I mentioned, one of the top three guns. Very good. Take a shot. Bang. All right. And then the pistol. Take a look at this one. Not bad. All right. The J358. It's actually not bad in game. Obviously, the ammo not being in color makes it awkward. But the reload looks pretty cool. So that's cool. That's cool. I'm just quickly glancing through because, let's be honest, this is really nice. This is one of my favorite ones. All right. The pistol. MW. Not bad. Not bad. Not bad. You guys can see the shooting animation, the reload animation. Looks pretty clean, actually. It's actually really a lot of gold. Really depends whether or not you like it or not, but with the attachment, it looks kind of whack. And that is all our gold guns. All right, that's it for today. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, like, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to let me know in the comments down below which one of these skins are your favorite. I love the BY-15. It's going to be my favorite, but any of the AK skins are actually really nice. The DRH as well as you can. Those are really clean, but let me know which one is your favorite. All right, I'm out. See you guys next time. Kill it.